Oh, they're shaping up all right, Aaron. Yeah, we just started to get there was a brief glimpse of sunlight, and then now this overcast is coming down, and so is the freezing rain as temperatures continue to dip below freezing out here in Plymouth. And again, as you mentioned, flooding has become a concern, especially with the ice jams just up and down the Pemigewasset. Let's take a look right down the street here. This is right off 175A, a student parking lot at Plymouth State University, resembling a lake as water from the Pemigewasset River covered it. You can see a little bit of water right now has overflown right onto 175A. Thankfully, PSU is not in session, so no cars were affected. And while the situation is pretty cosmetic right there, at worst, flooding is evident up and down the river. Several roads, as you mentioned, have been closed, including exit 25 off 93 South in Sharon. Route 123 near the Sharon Arts Center also closed. And in Newport, there's a detour along Elm on 11. And earlier, one lane of 89 northbound on Grantham was temporarily closed so crews could remove a vehicle that was stuck out there. Now, according to Holderness Police, no other parts of Plymouth State University or any nearby businesses have been impacted by the rising waters. They say the water is receding quickly. Of course, the other threat will be the freezing rain that, again, just starting to come down within the last hour. And that means there, of course, are slick roads, very slick walkway surfaces. So you're going to have to be very careful if you decide to leave your house. And this is just the start. Of course, there will be potentially more things. You just never know what's going to happen when you have an ice jam up and down the Pemigewasset River. Reporting live in Plymouth, Mike Cherry, WMUR News 9. And